The original plan was I was gonna do like a little bit of an animated intro to like start off the video of me building the gaming PC and just kind of give like a overview of what goes into it and basically what it does. But then I watched a video the other day. It was created by The Verge, and they basically made a gaming PC with a budget of $2,000. The catch is that they did really bad with it. And at first I thought it was satire, but he literally did not know what he was doing. And honestly, from my opinion, I think The Verge did a horrible job with that, because it's like, if they knew he was doing wrong but still uploaded it, it's like, you putting him under the bus. But other than that, the PC community basically sent this video, like sent a plea to react, like to a whole bunch of PC gurus and gaming PC creating pros. They sent them this video to react to it, to see their reaction on how bad he did. And prior to this, I already did about 2 weeks of research on the on just how to build a gaming PC, because before that I had no idea on how to do that. But then when I actually had about a 2 week experience, I was watching and I was able to realize a good portion of things that he was doing wrong. But then there were certain parts that in the video that I didn't even know was wrong to begin with. You know what I'm saying? So, and this is understandable, because the people that reacted to it are people who've been working with PCs for over 10 to 30 years. I only had about 2 weeks of like research, you know what I'm saying? So it's understandable. But then when I went back to the original idea of what I was gonna do, it's just like, it's best to not do that, because I don't know everything, or not enough to act like I'm professional at it, because I've seen enough gaming PC builds to think, oh, yo, this is gonna be straightforward. But I'm pretty sure when I start, everything's back here, when I start, I'm gonna run into some form of problem. So we're just gonna go through it, you know, with a good portion of me knowing, like understanding how it's supposed to go, but it's obviously never gonna hit a roadblock. We're gonna walk through with certain videos to, you know, help make sure that it's less chaotic than it would be if I didn't. Yeah, so I'm about to build a gaming PC, and I just wanna say now that if you're like a console player, but you always wanted to take a step into that gaming PC field, but you have no idea, like it was complicated to you, do it. You know, like I took the 2 weeks out of my life to like watch certain types of videos, and they're very entertaining, by the way. Now, the only problem I would say is getting a GPU would be a problem, but I was able to snipe mine off of eBay for a retail price, which I will talk more about later. But other than that, it's like, you know, take that time to watch the videos and, you know, get your mind into it, because it's actually more entertaining than you think. And that's what was kind of holding me back, other than money. But it's pretty cool. Like, you know, just take some time out your week to just look into it. You know, this very entertaining videos. All right. So starting off, we got our RAM, and this is XPG Gamex D20, 16 gigabytes of RAM, 2 sticks. So it's 8 per stick. And it's 3,200 megahertz. What is megahertz is, I have no idea. Now we're going to the CPU, which we have the, I'm covering the most important part, the AMD Ryzen 5 1600 AD. I know it's AF. It's AF because you look at the code up here. I'm not gonna zoom in too far, but at the end it says AF, just to make sure. And I saw this on Amazon, it was saying AF is better. So now we got the PSU, and for this one we have the smart 500 watt thermal take smart series power supply, and we got a little bit of a quote saying cool all your life. That's
really lame, man.
And we got the motherboard, we got the Asus Prime B450M-A. Made sure that it was Ryzen 3000 and Ryzen 5000 desktop ready, because I was gonna get a Ryzen 3, but then I saw the Ryzen 5 for a better price, and I heard AF was better. So next we have storage. So starting off with the SSD, we have the Barracuda Compute 480 gigabytes, and then honestly, the amount of games that I have on my laptop so far, I knew that wouldn't be enough, especially rendering my animations for around 4K resolution. Rendering about a 9-second video takes so much space because it goes into Adobe Media Encoder. And the file that starts off with is way too big. So I decided to get something even bigger. And I got this for about $50. It's the 2TB Barracuda 3.5 internal drive. Honestly, these look really cool, but I have no idea on how I'm going to put it into this case. All I literally know for real is how to put CPU, GPU, the power supply, and the RAM into this. You put that into this. Speaking of this, this is the case. We're going with a Musatex 970, if I'm correct. This is the one that has only 4 RGB fans, but I thought that would be fine because this CPU comes with its own cooling fan as well. So I believe this should be enough. Also, please let me know in the comments if you see something wrong with it. Like, give me tips. This is literally my first time, you know, making a gaming PC. So please let me know. And finally, we have the GPU, which is covered in bubble wrap, almost said foil. And the reason for this is because this is the first thing that came in the mail, and I didn't want it to collect dust while I was waiting for everything else. So I will unravel it real quick, just for a little bit, so y'all can see we have problems. And it's still dirty. I'll unravel it for a bit, just so you can see how it looks. And then we'll put it back when we're, we'll put it back and then have it up when we're ready to plug it into our case. Here we got the MSI Armor RX 580. This is the 4GB version. And it has OC at the end from the label that I saw. I'm guessing that means overclock. I might be wrong. But yeah, this was the one I was able to snipe on eBay for about $200. They messaged beforehand saying that they tested this for about 100% compatibility to make sure that it's fully working before sending it. And they didn't have enough boxes, so they put in bubble wrap. I checked to make sure everything was good. Everything is, from what I know, is fine. So yeah, that's all the pieces. Why did I take this off? It says, if you post a video on YouTube or Facebook, then you can contact us to get one of the following products as a gift. Word.
Have a little arrow. We're gonna line up that arrow with the arrow on the motherboard.
Okay, so let me go ahead and unbox this now before I move on to the next part. Honestly, Ryzen have some really good CPU cases. I like how they look. I did see an Intel. I saw an Intel box that looked crazy. It looked like a whole gym, and the processor was inside that gym. I saw it off of Young Don, the Sauce God's PC build that he was making. And I was just like, this was before I knew what a CPU was, so I really thought he was about to put a gym in his his PC. I'm about to say that's kind of OD, but it looks cool. I'm sure Editing Joseph will post, put a reference on the side while I'm unboxing this. All right, here we go. Installation instructions. We'll be following the walkthrough today, so no need for that. But I'm not gonna throw it away. That would be a big mistake. Here's the processor here. You got a little bit of weight to it. I mean, I'm sure it's supposed to, but this is the first time I'm, you know, doing this. And here's the cooling fan. Here. I'm just going to do that. Now, does this already have a thermal paste on it? Or, I'm gonna make sure. Until then, I'm gonna leave it right here. I'm being very careful because the CPU has pins at the bottom of it, which is used to operate everything. And if at least one of those pins are dented or messed up, the CPU will not work at all. Oh, is this a sticker? Okay. What I'm talking about is what I'm about to show you right now. You see those pins? All right, that's enough. I'm about to look at the video again to make sure I'm placing it right. We're gonna get everything we don't need out of the way.
So if you look closely at the CPU in the bottom left-hand corner, we have a little arrow. We're gonna line
up. Okay, so see that arrow here? That's it.
That arrow with the arrow on the motherboard, and on the motherboard it's on my top left as well. So go ahead and lift up the pin. Don't push it in, just lightly.
Oh, I think my motherboard is upside down. That arrow is on the top left. Yeah, okay. I'm doing it right now. It's on the top left.
If you look closely at the CPU in the bottom left-hand corner, we have a little arrow. We're going to line up that arrow with the arrow on the motherboard. And on the motherboard, it's on my top left as well. So go ahead and lift up the pin. Don't push it in.
Lift up the pin. Don't push it in.
Just lightly set it down into place because we don't want to bend the pin. So it should just fall in. Keep trying to get it to line up. And there you go. It falls in.
Okay. It's not all the way in. There we go. Yeah, I'll set everything up. Alright, all the pins are still fine. And I'm gonna line it with the arrow. Okay, he's in. It does, but you know YouTubers do it better. Why is it not? There we go. Cool. Alright, close the door.
Sticks of 4 gigabytes rated at 2666 megahertz. So when installing our RAM, it also just goes in one way, and you just want to make sure you hear it click and then you're good. As far as where we're going to be sticking our 2 sticks, we're going to be sticking it in the gray slots, so the second and the fourth one. So just go ahead and till you hear the click, and then just do the other one. The thing should just click it.
There we go. It didn't go in as smoothly as I thought it would, but it's in there. And
God!
Alright, I got those together. I'm sorry, out of everything that I've seen so far, the RAM looks the cleanest. It has such a glossy black finish and it's so nice. So keep in mind, the walkthrough that I'm doing right now doesn't have the same case as mine. He's using a different case, but I just wanted this one. So what I'm thinking is, after I put the motherboard in, because the stands are already there, when it's done, I'll screw these in to where it's supposed to be at. And if I have to add any more standoffs, then I already have some together. I'm gonna move the camera a little bit. Okay.
So I just placed the IO shield here
with the flaps facing.
All right.
So yeah, just line it up with the IO shield. And now we want to get it to just sit into place. So we won't even then have to hold it up. Okay, before, we want to make sure it clicks in. So yeah, just line it up with the IO shield. And now we want to get it to just sit into place.
All right, so in this case, I need to make sure that these standoffs, the little golden spots here, I need to make sure that they align with my motherboard. Or I'm gonna have to unscrew these and place them where they need to be. So align it with the IO shield. Okay. Now I can show y'all the angle that I'm talking about. All right. Still gonna be kind of hard to see. I'm gonna just take the camera off like this. All right, so it fits for the top three here that's supposed to align into. And for the two down here, I can see the gold standoffs here and here. But I have to move, I gotta insert some for here and here. So that's what I'm about to do.
CPU power cable, because I want to route it through here, but it won't fit if the motherboard's already screwed into place. So I'm gonna run that CPU power cable first, and then
too late yanking anything.
There we go. Jesus Christ, this feels like a snake, bro. This could be very easy or really bad. All right, we gotta remove the back plate before we even think about worrying about this power supply right now. So we're gonna move that out of the way. Move this out the way. All right, so honestly, the cord stuff wasn't even the problem. So it just took a little bit to maneuver and stuff like that. So first, let me show off the back. I'm gonna organize all this, all right? But I realized I did some research a little bit more. That's what took a little bit longer. I do have some extra cables with my PS here, or power supply. These two don't connect anywhere. Okay, I know these are SATA cables, but the motherboard already came with it. So let me show you the front. Here is the 2 terabyte hard drive, HDD, and here's the SSD. This is the only way I was able to connect it. I'm gonna just find a way to cover this because I don't like the fact that it's upside down. It says it's upside down, but when you go back here, but the writing on the back was right side up, but for some reason the other side is upside down. Oh yeah, I got a Adventure Time on in the background. But yeah, so it came with the motherboard came with SATA cables, which I plug in through here. Went all the way through. One of the SATA cables is plugging through the SSD here, and then the other one is all the way in the back and plugged up here where my index finger is. Now these are from the power supply. So this is giving the SSD power here, and then the other one is giving the hard drive power here. And yeah, so now everything else is plugged in through the motherboard, like the USB 3.0, the regular USB, the audio mount, like the audio cord, which is labeled HD audio, then the power for the motherboard. I think it's either up there or right here. Yeah, it's either one of these. Oh no, no, no. There's one for the CPU, and then there's another one for the, I think it's, I have no idea, but that's how I was supposed to plug it in. So that's how I did it. Everything is sturdy, no moving, nothing like that. Made sure to screw it in the way it needs to be. Oh, my back. Yeah, so at this point now, I'm about to put in the GPU and plug in the power cable for the GPU.
No!
Dang it. Word. Now we can get to the fun part, which I was honestly looking forward to do. So, MSI Armor RX 580 OC. Overclock, I think.
Into place, just push it in and it should clip in. So now just go ahead and see.
Okay, I was about to say. Okay, it's supposed to be upside down. Well, I guess in this case it's right side up. I'm gonna take this one off too, just in case. Keep in mind, I saw this on the review, that if you are trying to go with this and you find it in, like, you're having problems with the power supply you're looking for, make sure yours has 8 pins for the PCI. Either it'll just say 8 pins or it'll say 6 PCI+2. Either one is good. So. Now that we have the GPU fully connected and likewise for everything else, I will buy something so it can stop that little sag that's going on, because I don't like that doesn't sag a lot. Like, you really gotta look at it to see it, but it's not bad. To go ahead and organize the cables behind the back, behind here. And so, update, those weren't extra cables. Well, some of them are, but all of them weren't extra. So if you look here where the RGB controller, this red part, it's supposed to plug into, say, the power cable here. My finger is on. And that was supposed to plug into the PSU connector. Other than that, there is another cable that is for the RGB. I think this is like to change the color through the motherboard. So this is supposed to connect into a 5-volt RGB. But as you can see here, I only have a 12-volt RGB and it doesn't work. And I heard someone say not plug the VDG cable in there or it's going to fry it. So I'm not even going to attempt that. But they also said if it's not possible, you can use either a remote or the RGB button here to change the colors. So hopefully that works. But just to make sure that all the fans work on its own, I'm about to test it right now. I'm about to turn the PC on now just to see if all the fans work. And if they do, then I'll organize the cords and we move on to the next step. So please don't explode. It didn't turn on. We got to turn the switch on from the back here. Oh snap. That's not fire, that's just a yellow light. Now let's turn it on. Oh shoot. That's so cool, bro. Okay, now let's see if the RGB colors work. Okay, we got a wave going on. White. Blue and white. Yellow. Word. That's clean. I like that blue. Okay, so it's not the best cord organized. Like, I know some people get specific color cords to match their build. I wasn't worried about all of that. I just wanted to make sure that the power supply actually worked, you know? So, and it does, which is all I care about. When I either upgrade the setup or make a new one, then I'll worry about all the aesthetic parts. But right now, I was just worried about it working. That was it. Now, one thing I've seen a lot of PC builders do is to customize their PC by putting in the Funko Pop that kind of matches everything. So I bought one. Well, I got two because one was half off when I got it. So the first one I got, Static Shock. Yes, sir. So if I was gonna use this, I was gonna make sure that the RGB fans were like a yellow or a cobalt blue colorway. Cause it just works out well. All right, and the other one is Ozuna. Yeah, I did not know who who this person was until I got there. He's a Puerto Rican singer. Apparently, he's like very popular in that area. But I honestly got it just because he has a whole white, you know, outfit on. Which one am I gonna use first? Let's use both. I find it hard to believe if these are valuable or not. I mean, that these are valuable. No. Okay, it looks like I can only use one. I don't think the other one's gonna fit. Yes, sir, my boy. All right. Will he fit? No, he will not. Wait a minute. No. I was like, could I put him up here? But I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna just keep one on the side. So Static Shock, you'll get your turn, bro. Just not right now. Had me scared that I fried it or something. There we go. Into the computer, have everything set up with the outlet down here, and I was gonna put it under here, but I'm not trying to worry about like heating and air control and them like that. I ain't trying to worry about none of that. So, and it has a really good, like, the stands on all four legs, like it has enough space for it to like freely, you know, for the fan to do what it needs to do. For the monitor, I got a on 1080p, has a 60 refresh rate, but no built-in speakers, which is why I'm using my Bluetooth speaker. But more than likely, I'm going to use my headphones when I'm on my PC. And yeah, so at this point, I'm going to turn it on and try to set up the drivers. But first off, I want to see what it does when it first starts up. So it took a minute for the driver to install on the USB here that I'm using, but now it's together. I'm sorry, bro. Look at that white. It looks so good, bro. Especially with the Funko Pop, it just tops it off. But back to what I was saying. Yeah, so I installed the driver, like the BIOS or whatever it is, on the USB. I'm also going to credit the video that I watched for that one on how to install Windows on your computer for free. It's not no type of pirating or nothing like that. I downloaded this straight from the Windows website, so. And yeah, now we're about to install it. All right, so yeah, I got boy Belize in the background while I was cleaning up. So the setup is done. The setup is completely done. I was able to move everything over to my computer with no problems. It just took forever though. Now you see here, I got all the games and the launchers and all that other good stuff on the left side. Also downloaded two things for this GPUID. Well, it's regularly called GPU-Z. It just basically shows everything like hardware wise to let you know what you're using. All right, so now I'm about to go ahead and test some of these games out, and
Yeah, so it'll be a flip of seeing it from this perspective and then screen recording to see if it, you know, if it can handle all that. Alright, I was able to get the controller to work now. So we're not gonna do nothing crazy, we're just gonna drive down the road with the car, see if we can get some high speeds, and then probably shoot something up. See the cars explode and see if the frame rate goes down a little bit. And then from there, we'll move on to the next game. I'm not gonna take too long with this, you know, just doing a simple test. Okay, okay, okay. My sensitivity is mad. The view is crazy though. And the thing is, like, the crazy thing is, like, the quality of this game, like, the performance, everything is on high right now. And compared to the PS5, this junk is moving way smoother than I thought, even though the reflections are really good. Where you going, Cup? Taking your cop car. Leo. There we go, I'm starting to pick up speed. No, road spikes! I don't think I have the rock. There we go. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. It was a really fun project, honestly, putting everything together. And this PC is probably gonna last me a really long time. I know that the recording, I didn't set everything up perfectly for the recording, so I know that the quality is probably kind of iffy up there, but like, looking at it from the monitor, it looked way better than it did on my PS5. I'm not trying to like, stretch nothing. It actually looked way better. Like, the amount of FPS I was getting was crazy. The only stagger I would see was when the game would load, but other than that, it's like, the PC definitely does its job, and I'm more than beyond happy, so. That's basically it. If y'all enjoyed the video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all on the next one.